Welcome to this short Teams Manager demo where I show you what Teams Manager can do for you in terms of governance, project management, and an easier environment that has no uncontrolled growth. Teams Manager gives users an overview of their teams they're responsible for, including owners, members, additional metadata, and much more. So the end user has an easy overview of everything. He can create new teams from here, and not only that, but SharePoint sites, Yammer communities, communication sites, and if you like, much more. If we jump into the background of the Teams Manager, we see that there is a very, very easy settings menu where you can do your governance in very easy steps. For example, naming conventions for different projects, different kinds of teams, for example, like having a custom prefix, suffix, metadata, and so on. And the same is for OneNote and Planner. Lifecycle management that you can just easily set up by sliding down this bar to notify people when a team expires or even delete a team after a certain amount of time. The communication of Teams Manager is really smooth. So it sends people chat messages when teams expire or when they are getting archived. If so, a team user can always say, "Hey, stop, I still need that team," and extend the lifecycle. This way, Teams Manager helps people to maintain a clean environment and at the same time have rolled out teams to work in there that are not blank, but with a lot of content. For example, my project IT Microsoft team here. It has not only a naming convention that is automatically rolled out while creating it, it also has a channel structure, it has a private channel, it has predefined folder structures, and, for example, a predefined planner. So that's a short overview of Teams Manager. If you want to try it out, just download it. You can get it in the store. It just takes 2 minutes to get you up and running. Have fun.